tire sur lui, il va pas y avoir.
Tu peux être plus comme ça, tu vas être en avant-plan.
Quand il est sur la table,
un démon. Oui, sur la table.
That was our first goal. To try to make a great film, try to be at the same level as Bourne Identity or Die Hard or whatever, you know. What was really difficult in Transport 3 was to prepare all the stunt things with the small time we had. The script is so great, everything is bigger. In the two first ones, the scenes were very short, the action scenes were very short. In this one, they are really big, they are really intense, they are going higher and higher. So everything has been felt bigger. So that was for me really a challenge to complete this. Director Jason Statham was very very funny because it's very complete. He's leading to be a kind of Bruce Willis because his face, because his charisma and so on. When you see the shape of his body in the film, it's so incredible. Nice. When Luke gives me Transport 3, it was to change the look of Jason. And the look of Jason of Frank Martin was closer to a Dior look, you know. So we try to have the smarter, the most elegant and aesthetical costume that could fit to Frank Martin.
Slow, move.
Each time there is a stunting, it was there, you know. It was there and wanted absolutely to do it, you know. Absolutely. See, I want to do it. I can do it. The tricky thing is to try to make fit the stunt. The stunt guys and the like doubles and so on with the actor. And with Jason, there is no way because he's doing everything.
A lot of the time, people want to go with someone that has a visual look rather than a physical skill. So when you're fighting an untrained stuntman, it becomes very, very difficult. You might have a great face, but in turn, doesn't really have any reaction technique or doesn't have any experience in sort of stunt fighting. So there's a balance there. Do you have someone that looks good or do you have someone that is a little bit more skilled but doesn't look quite as good? So this was something where Luc Besson became very instrumental. Him and Olivier are the people that are responsible for choosing the stuntmen.
Trop romantique, celui-là.
Et on fait ce chant là au début.
In terms of the action, it's completely different to the first two. Luc Besson wanted to give it a new kind of flair, a new sort of polish. So it's definitely a new tempo.
Ah!
there is a really a villain, a real villain, like in Grid Action Movie, played by Robert Knepper, who caused a new duality between Frank Martin with the hero and him.
Mr. Johnson is a character that is, he's very educated and sophisticated. He's also a very dangerous man, and that's why he's hired to do this kind of dirty work.
Working with Robert, I was so proud of it, you know. You see him at the first time, and that's the first time we had the same, exactly the same idea about the character, because it was a brand new character.
Good, very good.
He has very clear, focused opinions about things, and luckily, we're on the same page, and I totally get him. I really, really loved working with him.
I took the liberty of bringing your suit. It's what you wear when you're working, correct?
Correct. But I'm not working. I think it sort of harks back to the first one in some ways. You know, Frank, we find, is actually working again, because in part two, he's retired. I'm still unavailable.
Boss, can I say something?
Anyone else want to say something?
Sit. And action. And cut.
He refuses a job because the situation is not quite right.
You have 3 seconds to change your mind, or you're going to be permanently unavailable.
Everything that he does is by his own standards and by his own sort of rules. So if something doesn't match those rules, he doesn't take the job. But
one condition. I'm listening. I drive my own car.
Preparing stunts in Transport 3, the first thing was to have the to be with the good team.
L'audi qui vient vers nous et qui fait ça.
T'as compris, toi?
The good team was, for example, Michel Julien, who is one of the greatest stunt car stunts you can find everywhere in the world. Even, you know, in US they call him because it's so great.
Comme ça, si on est un poil plus généreux, ça se pointe comme ça.
Tu peux pas taper comme ça de vue.
At the very beginning, when I read the script, it was obvious that we have to shoot the action scenes real. It was written like this, you know. When I read the first thing and I saw Look After, I said a lot of things has to be done in real. The car, they have to drive very, very, very fast at the real speed.
To the beginning, still with the proper introductions. I'm Frank Martin.
What happened to the rule of no names?
Working with Sasha was great because It was our first experience making films. As soon as I saw her, I saw something very generous, you know, because she wanted to do her best every day. And that was really amazing to see her learning so fast, to see her learning so much. And we tried to really to give her to be the best in the film. And that's what I think we managed to do.
There is something wrong with me. Am I not sexy?
Very sexy.
You're the gay.
Well, I'm not the gay.
Going through the new Frank Martin's character was the challenge. In this film, is falling in love. And that gives him more humanity than ever.
Wow, it brings some sexuality and colors and softness and some craziness, because my character is really crazy and lots of fun. I think it brings a lot of flavor.
Give me the keys.
Come on, Frank Martin. Make playtime for me.
I knew this little intricate chess game between these two players was coming to a head in this big fight.
I'd like to offer you a position.
I'd like to offer you one. I'm gonna lead this segment.
I read it, I thought, oh my God, it just keeps going on and on and on and on. It'll be very interesting to see what the style of the fight will be. And it's a long fight.
Yeah, I'll just take it, and when I hear him, that's when I turn.
When you're the down, he's coming.
Quelque chose à ajouter.
Merci à tous, c'est une fin de journée.